Good evening. Accusations of dirty tactics, explicit leaked photos, and a minister's undisclosed shares in a road toll giant. Tonight, scandal is engulfing both sides of state politics just weeks out from the election. The Premier could have to sack his right-hand man, while Chris Minns has lost his star pick candidate.
A rare moment of serenity.
Just listen to the cicadas.
For a Premier who can't seem to catch a break. Tonight, Dominic Perrottet left mulling whether to sack one of his most senior confidants. Finance Minister Damien Tudor hopes sprung over his share portfolio. His trust owns interests in toll giant Transurban, and he's been sitting at the table as Cabinet made critical decisions, including one to subsidise drivers using the company's motorways.
If I had known, which I did not, I would have disclosed that interest as part of those discussions.
There are clear requirements in respect of ministers and their disclosures. I have sought that advice from DPC Legal.
The Premier has already accepted one resignation today. Upper House MP Peter Poulos, after he shared explicit photos of colleague Robin Preston from the 80s, to whom he's already apologised. For Dominic Perrottet, cutting loose Damien Tudorhope would be a personally difficult decision.
For voters, this could put another question mark over the integrity of this government, and it rounds out a horror week for the Premier.
But Labor's campaign is starting to wobble too.
And an in four.
Leader Chris Minns today losing a star candidate in a key seat. Retired Raiders player Terry Campese pulling out of the race for Monaro in the wake of a series of damaging revelations.
A lot of people that I spoke to said that I was silly to get involved and how dirty politics can get. And we've seen that start to come to light over the past 2 weeks.
Can you win without him?
It'd be very difficult.
The loss of Campese narrows Chris Minns's path to majority government. Labor needs 11 seats to win. In Western and Southern Sydney, it could snatch as many as 9. It had 4 in play in the bush, but Monaro is now virtually out of contention, requiring a near clean sweep of targets to make Mr. Minns the Premier.
Every election campaign, this one included, would be a roller coaster, and this one's proving to be just that.
A wild ride with 5 weeks still to run, but today was hardly a thrill for either leader. Liz Daniels, Nine News.
And state politics reporter Liz Daniels joins me now in studio because you have some breaking news on this extraordinary day in politics.
Georgie, just in the last couple of minutes, the Premier has released a statement saying he has accepted the resignation of the Finance Minister, Damien Tudorhope. The advice from his department was that Damien Tudorhope did not knowingly breach the ministerial code of conduct, but rather, anyway, he has still accepted that resignation, and that the Premier, Dominic Perrottet, will take on the role of Finance Minister. It would have been a very personally difficult decision for him, Georgie. He and Damien Tudorhope are very close confidants.
Unbelievable day. Liz, thank you.